You can have all the money in your hands, all the possessions anyone can ever have, but it's all worth this treasure. True worth is only measured not by what you got, but what you got in your heart. You can have everything. But what does it mean? It all means nothing if you don't stand up for something. You can't just talk the talk. You got to walk that walk. Yes, you do. It all means nothing if you don't stand up for something. And I stand up for you. And I stand up for you. Yes, I will. Yes, I will. You do the best, do the best that you can do. Then you can look in the mirror, proud of who's looking back at you. Define the life you're living, not by what you take, but what you're giving. And if you bet on love, there's no way you'll ever lose. Take a stand, make a stand for what's right. It's always worth, always worth the fight. It all means nothing, yeah, if you don't stand up for something. You can't just talk the talk. You got to walk that walk. Yes, you do.
This is the Tanya Free and Friends Talk Show, your destination for the best in social and political straight talk. And now, here's your host, Miss Tanya Free.
Today is Wednesday, March the 7th. Welcome to the Tanya Free and Friends Talk Show. I am Tanya Free, joined by my wonderful friends, Tim Baskerville. How are you?
Doing all right. How are you?
Good. And also with us is Sherrod Brown. How are you, friend? Good. I am okay. I'm not going to complain about anything. I know it doesn't do any good anyway. And working behind the scenes is Noah Johnson, Niles Johnson, Marcus Evans, and Mr. Free. Thank you all for being here today. We want to welcome all of our listeners from coast to coast for joining the conversation today. Our phone lines are open. Give us a call at 804-321-1010. Our toll-free number, 844-321-1010. Or you can text us at TanyaFree63975 or download the TuneIn app to listen to us on your mobile phone by dialing 712-832-2784. Thanks to our friends at AMFM247. It's Women's History Month. And shout out to all the sisters, all the women, I should say. When I say sisters, I mean everybody. I don't mean just black. I mean everybody. You know, I do. When I say sis, I may see a white person.
I have to clarify that.
Yeah, well, I mean, I don't want anybody to say, oh, you just talking about. Yeah, right. Exactly. So, you know, one thing about women, we, for the most part, we pull together, unite, and truly we are making a difference every day in everything that we do. Don't look at me like that, Tim.
I'm just engaging.
That's what that is? Okay. Well, let's jump right into it. 45 is seeking re-election, and I am surprised that the media is not making a big deal about that. And I have a problem with that, for he is actively, on a down low, preparing for his re-election. He's already named a campaign manager, Brad Parscales, I believe his name is, and he is gearing up for a tour to raise massive amounts of money, which makes a huge difference.
May or may not.
It does.
It may or may not. I'm going to restate that issue, because here's the thing. I think, again, under a traditional issue where you just had traditional prior to Trump coming in and just doing all this nonsense, I think that would have been a fair statement. But if you look at key races in Pennsylvania, where the GOP is outspending the Democratic Party 17 to 1%, and is barely ahead, and actually in some parts of that state are under the water. Some of the issues that are throwing things in the mix are the Supreme Court of the United States and the Pennsylvania Supreme Court looking at the issue of gerrymandering. Number two, the fact that you have a lot of money being raised doesn't necessarily overcome the sheer just... We have had a record number of protests. We've had a record number of people leaving this office. We've had a record number of really the majority of populism. Okay, and I don't want people to be confused. Populism doesn't just mean fascist or right-wing populism. It means rule that is generated by the popular, by people, okay, not by the parties. Okay, so you have all of this just dissatisfaction, to be polite, with Trump's rule. Essentially rule, not governing, rule. He wants to be the next China's Xi Jinping, whatever his name is.
That's what he's saying.
So, getting back to the point is this, is that you can have a lot of money, and that is not really, I think, going to stem the level of just backlash, voter backlash, that Trump and the GOP are causing themselves.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but I don't want us to be...
Is that Marty Jewell?
He's going to join us in a minute. I don't want us to take anything for granted, because, you know, I think we were all just, you know, blown out of the water, being that he won this first time. Period.
Well, and you know, that's a
and
good
we need
point
to be real,
too.
Real careful, because the thing is this: he started to say things like, "Oh, I don't want to be a one-term president." You know, President Obama was too. That's red meat to his base, and things like that. You know, running on negativity works. And it galvanizes his base, and they will start to just all kinds of stuff start to happen. Like I said, I don't want us to take that for granted. Also, too, when I say he can raise or will plan to raise massive amounts of money, just think about the tax cut he gave corporations, and it works in their favor for him to be reelected. So we can't take anything for granted. His base, you know, being racially, driven, the corporation, which it works in their advantage for him to be reelected, because he will do whatever it is they pay him to do.
Those are good points. You know, I think additionally, though, you also then have to look at that. I keep going back to this. This is a key issue of people being so incensed, and people being incensed also translates into economic dollars spent.
True.
So you look at the dollars spent per se. Look, Delta tried to get out ahead of that. When you have the students who have protested and this and that, so now what they're trying to do is show, hey, we have corporate responsibility and morality and so on and so forth, but a big reason is because they know that popular anger translates into economic dollars being lost. And I think they're hedging their bets or looking at what works for them. And they're saying, I think, that the GOP's initiatives and what they're doing are going to last but so long. Because you have, I guess, Georgia, I think it was, just recently said that they were going to look at eliminating some tax loopholes on jet fuel, which doesn't just affect Delta. It affects, really, the commercial airline industry.
Right.
Which, it's that has been the GOP's problem. Shooting itself in the foot. Time and time again, and really putting out contradictory messages to say, hey, we're here for labor, we're here for the blue collar.
But they're still in office, they're still there.
And I think, you know, they've just stirred up too much of a hornet's nest in terms of environmental and in terms of every movement you want to see. I think that they are going to lose a lot of seats.
We will see in November.
You're looking at, what, 60, I think there are about 66 seats that either lean to or are toss-up seats for the GOP, as opposed to 15 on the Democratic side.
Then the other question is this: what is the Democratic Party doing to make sure he's not reelected? Sherrod? What do you think?
I think that many did take a lot for granted before.
Right.
I don't think that is the case this time around. I think that also, even with the Democratic Party, I think that the quiet, so to speak, is purposeful, I believe. And again, if you look at a lot of the comments about, everybody was pretty much blindsided, you know, when he actually won the election, not even his own party took it seriously. So I think that they may be galvanizing, you know.
Oh, they are.
Yeah.
They are.
But they are, but I believe that the Democratic Party is as well.
And I want to know what it is they're doing.
Maybe there's...
What are they doing?
Well, you know, here's...
If he's already started and he's raising money and he's campaigning now as he's in office, we can't wait until, you know, 2020 say, okay, you know, we're going to get going. No, well, they're already...
I think the issue is this.
I'm just trying to make sure this doesn't happen again, y'all. I'm just saying.
Well, I think the issue is this for the Democratic Party. It's really not in terms of... what is your message? You know what the Democratic Party message is number one. I think, number one, they could run on just saying reverse everything Trump's done. Let's be real, because what that necessarily means is reinstalling or reinvigorating entitlement programs, you know, towards the elderly or homeless and so on and so forth.
Well, health care.
We're going to health care, you know, whether we want to look at protecting our environment and inserting those Obama regulations, gun control issues, whether so you could really almost as a Democrat just run on the same positions most progressives have said from day one. It's about social fairness, equality, and equity. That covers every point that Trump has caused problems with, whether it's racial, gender, immigration, so on and so forth.
Let me tell you the reason why I have a problem with that. It's because it's like a back and forth game we're doing here. We like President Obama, you know, we had health care, far as, you know, a lot of programs that were put in place during President Obama's era. And now, you know, the GOP, Trump, and the N45 have, done all of that. Now we're supposed to put, you know, Democrats back in place so we can go back to where we were before. Is it back and forth? I want more than that.
I want far more than that. And I think, you know, that there's a fair point. But the baseline question is, what are the... So I don't know that Democrats necessarily have to say what are they running on. I think it's really improving the logistics of how are we going to do it. So it's not like, where are you coming from? It's just...
That's a good question. I understand, how are we going to do it?
I understand where you're coming from. Just, you know, because we have not had... And I think that's the key issue and the one benefit that Trump has provided the United States, a veritable blueprint for everything we need to improve and really just correct, whether it's violations of federal law with Kellyanne Conway and the Hatch Act, whether it's immigration issue, whatever it is, Trump has laid a veritable blueprint of where we need to shore up to protect our democracy or prevent things from happening.
The reason I can't just be comfortable with that is the fact that he is still in office. Now, all the stuff that he has done, all of the craziness that has gone on with him, had that been President Obama, do you think he would still be in office right
now?
Sure,
they would have started impeachment proceedings long before
right,
now.
Right, that's
they
my point.
Have. Sure.
That's my point. Why hasn't that happened?
Well, you know, I mean, I don't know why people keep asking why. Because the GO party is catering to the last 30%. It really simmers down to about, you haven't seen numbers go above really 40, 41, depending on the poll, but it really simmers down to that last 35% boiled down, simmered down base of just white anger and bigotry.
Because, I don't know why people. And that's how he can be reelected.
I disagree because you are looking at the waves where even. Places, whether it's in Dallas, whether it's in Pennsylvania, whether it's in Wisconsin, whether it's in all of these places, if you're actually keeping track of state and federal elections, there shouldn't even be a Tejana, which is Latina, a Tejana from Texas, being in a true race. She shouldn't even be on, in terms of a Hispanic female coming from that particular district, a competitor. She is. You look at black males in Texas, some of them, former NFL player, what's his name, Allred, he is a competitor. You look at some of these areas, Doug Jones,
I think Ted Cruz is being challenged.
He is. You're right.
Right,
but I don't know what district it is. It's Beto O'Rourke is his one of the major primary winners there. And I think under Texas law, they have, if nobody gets like 50% of the primary vote, then I think there's a runoff.
And you mentioned Pennsylvania. They have an election. Is it next week?
It is. I believe so. I would have to check that. Don't quote me on it, but I think so. So we're really getting into the special election season before the November. This is the midterms and special elections. So,
okay, during a break, I'm gonna look it up and see where that is. Because this is the conversation that the media should be talking about. Not all of this craziness, you know, with who, you know, 45 slept with. I could care less about that right now.
But
because was that?
I mean, think about it. I always stand by, you know, it's deliberate. You know,
right. They,
you know, when you think about who owns, you know, the majority of many of the media outlets, particularly television, it's deliberate. You know, that's,
right.
You know, so we're saying what they shouldn't be doing. But if you think about where they get their orders, you know, who cares about whoever whatever the affair was? I don't care. I'm not interested. You know,
I care.
We have to be extremely careful.
That is some saucy stuff.
Well, that's why we have to be extremely careful.
I think this is the only reason, I'm joking aside, whether it's a porn star or not in this case. But, I mean, it goes to a repeated pattern of really I think things that, at the end of the day, once Mueller is done with his investigation, these are all things that Democrats will certainly take from that investigation and put in articles of impeachment.
Just like the GOP went after Hillary, you know, with her email and placing in our memory that, okay, she, you know, lock her up and all these, this negativity, they started that early on.
Yeah.
You know, so where
poor logistics. They should. This is the one thing I think, we agree on several other things, Tanya, but one of the things we talked about earlier that I specifically agree with you on is I'm sick of the Democrats. Being too cautious and missing opportunities
that they could exploit. That's how he can be reelected. Let me do this. Let me, before we go to break, read some of the comments.
Okay. Let's see. Longtime listener says, if Bernie, who is not a Democrat, is the best the Dems have, yes, 45 will be reelected. Candace says, he could and will if we don't have an alternative. Nuance says no way. Warren said, who in the Democratic Party has enough appeal to compete? I don't think another African American or a woman will be elected. Susan says, yes, he could. I would vote for Cory Booker. Longtime listener in Memphis said, 45 is unraveling and is threatening trade wars and not so white lies. Robert Brown J says, yes, because he is a master of distraction. Have we already forgotten about the children killed in Florida? Don't allow him to change the conversation. We need gun control, not armed teachers. Lena said, I will vote for anyone who will not support putting handguns in the hands of teachers. Benjamin said, I think he will, because the Democrats are silent about who will challenge 45. Dems are focused on the investigation. Trump will not be impeached. He has been to be voted out. Tanya, I ask that you not let the gun issue die down. The networks have already moved on, and states are putting guns on teachers. See, Curious says, MAGA. Trudy said, yes, he can be reelected. We didn't believe it the first time. Let's not make the same mistake again. I like Keith Ellison, but America would never elect a Muslim. Daniel said, yes. Kelly said, Lord, I pray not.
Okay, hold on to that. We got to take a break.
No.
Today's praise break. Ain't no need to worry about Anita Baker and the Winans. Sponsored by the Choice 105.3 FM, Richmond.
So we come back, Lord,
in the morning. Comes and covers all the day.
in the morning.
Tanya Free and Friends Talk Show is sponsored in part by
Metropolitan Day School, where eagles soar.
This is Tanya Free. Have behavioral issues affected your child's grades? Does it seem like your child's emotional problems are tearing you and your family apart? Calls from the principal, suspensions, detentions? Call my friends over at Metropolitan Day. Get your child's school year and your family back on track. Call Ms. Thomas today, 804-321-2595. Metropolitan Day, where eagles soar.
Tanya Free and Friends celebrate Black History 365 days a year. Live life with a purpose with Tanya Free and Friends.
This is Tanya Free, inviting you to check out the Tanya Free and Friends Talk Show, your destination for the best in social and political straight talk, here coast to coast on the AM-FM 247 radio network and the AM-FM 247 television network. Join the conversation.
The Tanya Free and Friends Talk Show, Wednesdays. Put your business on the map for a lot less than you might think with Freedom Marketing. Text the word ADVERTISE to 63975 or give them a call at 844-321-1010. That's Freedom Marketing, join the conversation. Phone lines are open right now at area code 804-321-1010 in Central Virginia and 844-321-1010 coast to coast.
I want to welcome my friend, former Richmond Councilman Marty Jewell. How are you, friend?
I'm fine. Good to see y'all. Sorry I'm late.
Well, that's okay. We're glad you're here. Why don't you jump into the conversation? Wait a minute. We got to go to the phones right quick. Hey, Scotty, how are you?
I'm doing the best I can. How are you?
We're doing good.
That's great. That's great to hear. I just wanted to comment on the interesting conversation y'all having about, you know, Donald Trump already hiring a campaign manager and preparing for the 2020 election. I think money does matter, but it does not always matter, because you got to look at Hillary Clinton had far more money than Donald Trump, and she still lost. So,
okay.
You
That's
know.
A good point.
I guess it depends on how you spend that money and, you know, how persuasive your campaign ads are. But money does matter. But we have seen the last election cycle, the candidate with far more money and resources losing to Donald Trump. Now, in terms of the Democrats, they do have to go through the process, Tanya, in terms of who's going to be the Democratic nominee to run for president. You know, we still got to go through a primary right. and all that. I know the last time they preordained Hillary Clinton to be the nominee,
right.
you know, based on them documents that came out. And I don't think they want to do that again.
Right.
Because of the way they ran that primary in the fashion that they did, I believe that's why Donald Trump is president. A lot of people, especially people who are supporting Senator Sanders, voted for Trump. A lot of them was like, no, we're not going to reward this bad behavior, this rigged primary, and we either going to vote for Jill Stein or somebody else. And I think that's what happened. Now, in terms of their nominees, this is the three, if they decide to run, that I see may have a shot. It was mentioned, Cory Booker was mentioned. I would say Kamala Harris, although personally I don't like some of her past policy positions in California, and Sanders. One of those three, I believe, if they become the nominee, that they could beat Trump.
You really think an African-American can beat 45?
It depends on the policy. It depends on the policy. I don't think skin color matters.
Oh, yes, it does.
It matters more now.
It matters more now.
Well, then, Sanders, then, is the only one that got a chance, because nobody else has that name recognition. I only mentioned Kamala Harris and Cory Booker because of their name recognition. But if y'all don't think that they could beat Trump, I think they could beat Trump if they had the right policy position.
If I can be a bit of a contrarian here, I think
sure.
we're way too early to be talking about the eventuality of a Democratic Party nominee. They're quiet for a reason. They spend a lot of money on consultants to tell them to keep your damn mouth shut.
But I think that's a mistake, though.
Hold on. No. Anything coming out of the National Democratic Party and the Congress right now can spoil chances for folks running in local congressional districts. If you saw what happened to that race down in Texas, they reported this morning, where the National Democrats got involved trying to pick one Democrat over another, and there was a backlash. And the person that they tried to shut down won, or she didn't win. She got enough votes in order to be involved in the two-way
runoff. Yeah, but that's infighting. Yeah. That's infighting, though.
No,
within the party.
But it comes from there, especially in Texas.
But that does matter, though. I do agree with him.
Yeah, they don't want to interfere with these local elections during this midterm elections coming out of D.C.
A progressive challenge. The Democratic Party, they are basically in a civil war right now. It's
yes.
just not playing out
that's
in
right.
the media.
And so are the Republicans, for that matter.
Yeah, but I mean, I agree with him that it is too early. But since that's the topic of the conversation, you know, with Donald Trump filing and hiring the campaign,
I don't think we're going to have to worry about it, Scotty, because the boy going to be in jail by December.
No,
he's going down.
I don't know about
that.
Going down. That might be a bit much. But, you know, I'm just piggybacking. You know, I think that's 100% right. You know, both sides are pretty much fighting, infighting with each other. And we saw that, though. This was going back, though, before the last election campaign kicked in, when really the movement on Wall Street kind of started a couple of years back. So you had this really shift for progressive people and then the Democratic Party. And I think this is all you're seeing is the same kind of continuation of the same thing, that the Democratic Party more so working for itself rather than where its base is moving to. And that's going to create a lot of conflict.
Well, they're going to have to craft a national messaging because what they got ain't working. And
I agree with you.
And I don't think, Scotty, they can do that until these midterms are out of the way. That gives them 2 years to go headlong at their strategy, unraveling their strategies for 2020. But you can't get ahead of the class on this stuff because our people are so fickle. The voters are fickle.
True. And that's why he can be reelected, for the mere fact that a lot of people stayed home, didn't like Hillary. We are frustrated with, you know, the Democratic Party, which has been quiet and the same old, same old.
And putting up candidates that, like, you know, if your base is saying, I don't want this person, and you're like, hey, let's put them up.
And especially the millennials. Millennials, like, okay, they want some fresh blood, they can say do what they did last time and say, okay, we are not going to jump on the bandwagon just because you're Democratic.
Our choices that we're talking about right now may not be the choices in the next 2 year cycle. We don't know who might pop up that will be head and shoulders over who's being offered now as possible.
Maybe a third party.
Well, I think we need
there's going to be a third party.
That is not a realm of possibility.
But, you know,
I think message is going to matter. Policy is going to matter more than the person. You know, earlier it was mentioned about, you know, populist candidates and populist issues. Whoever this next candidate is going to be, well, I would say the Democratic Party right now, needs to adopt some of those policy proposals that were very, very popular that Senator Sanders was putting forth, like the tuition-free state colleges and universities, eliminating private prisons.
Well, they need to put that forth, but none of that's going to happen from the federal level until certainly after November of this year, at the very earliest.
Well,
okay,
being put forth by a candidate.
Right.
Okay.
Right. We can put forth policies. That's
to
just
take
not going to be an
effort in Congress. But what I'm saying is, the candidate himself, like Sanders, was pushing those issues. They need to adopt those issues because that's where the country is moving towards, whether they right wingers or left wingers. That some of those policies resonated with the populace.
Well, you know, and they did, but we need to start from the ground up again. Again, my point beforehand was that the federal government, I think Russia did a great job in really just this frozen conflict and really just incapacitating the federal government. No, they did a great job because you look at the number of positions unfilled, you look at the lack of a policy for anything coming from Trump. They did a great job paralyzing the federal government.
Yeah, they did.
Period. So my point is that the state and local governments need to pick up the slack. Just like I think one of the topics you were going to talk about is this net neutrality thing.
Right.
And Washington became the first state to go ahead and pass a law.
Right.
Virginia should be looking at that. So the point is, these federal candidates for federal offices can go ahead and put out a platform. But number one, it's not going to be implementable until at least November. But before then, okay, while some of those, I think we still have 2 weeks left in the General Assembly session, these states need to start picking up the slack where we don't have that's what I'm saying. So if we want things to get done and implemented, not just campaign rallies, and we know what the platform is. The issue is how to and actually implementing these policies and not talking.
Okay, let me ask this question. Okay, we the state government is picking up the slack, but what do we want our federal to do? What are we holding them responsible for?
I think you skipped over
that I was bringing up. But again, I cannot buy that the Russians is preventing cabinet positions or any of these federal positions that would be appointed by the executive branch. The Russians are holding that up, unless you're telling me the Democrats who are dragging their feet, which they should, you know, resist his nominations and whatnot. Unless you're telling me the Russians controlling them, I just can't buy into
that's what I was going to weigh in on. I can't let you get away with the Russians did us a favor. Hold on.
No, I didn't say did us a favor. I didn't say did us a favor.
They shook things up.
I never said that. I said they were successful in
infiltrating.
Right. Exactly.
Right.
Infiltrating. Yeah.
They were successful in infiltrating.
I didn't say they did us a favor. I said they were successful in really in paralyzing
the United States government.
I'm
talking about the offices that were not filled with...
Because
let me finish.
Marty, because you're making no sense, and I know where you're going.
Okay, wait a minute. Let Marty finish. Go ahead, Marty.
What I'm saying to you is we are finding out, even before Mueller's final reports, that we've had a government takeover. Trump and his people will be charged with sedition. That Trump and his crowd will allow Putin to dictate where to put diplomats and where not. Which is what is becoming apparent.
That's what I just said.
Exactly. That's what he just said.
This is a
in order for it to happen, it had to be 45 and his people.
Correct.
Yes.
Like he just said. Right. He was successful with putting 45 and his people.
Right.
It's the same thing as like, you know, the U.S. spending money on PSYOPs campaign and PSYOPs warfare. And, you know, if we want to even take this out of the context or realm of warfare, because it works, actually, but if we want to take it out there, why would companies spend hundreds of millions of dollars in advertising if they can't essentially make you buy the car, but they can affect your mindset, which makes you buy the car? So it's the same issue as what Russia has been doing. They've just run a very perfected, over years of looking at this. They started doing this in the 40s. The 40s, the 50s, the 60s. And that's how Trump, and one reason why Trump is in the office and the people he has around him have been essentially selected in this Manchurian
folks
candidate
that are not
way.
Even qualified. Yes. You know? And that's why we need to take this situation for us, him being reelected in 2020, very seriously.
Yes.
Because it can happen again.
Well, Scotty? Tanya, as a journalist who takes journalism very serious, and no, I don't work for the New York Times or anything like that, but I do my own research and I write for black people. I have to distance myself from these Russian comments, because I've seen no evidence, and I'm not just your average everyday caller or something like that. I do this for a living, been doing it for the past 10 years, and I've seen no evidence whatsoever that Putin controlled this or
that. Well, you might have to get another job. There's a lot of circumstantial evidence.
Let me finish.
And let's just say, for the sake of argument, that they paid for some little Facebook ads and what have you and whatnot. It's no different than what the United States does. There's video of Hillary Clinton begging Congress for billions of dollars so they can influence elections and stuff in other countries using media.
Well, you know, again, and I'm just going to have to say this. I mean, you're like, I've done my research and all of this. I mean, you haven't done your research, because, number one, if you've
been... Yes,
hey, hold on. I let you talk. No, I let you talk.
Scotty,
let you talk.
Go ahead.
I let you talk.
Let
you
talk, Scotty. Go ahead.
So then you need to do your research. No, you do. Okay, Scotty, thanks. But anyways, you do need to do it, because this was such an extensive campaign that was done through... not just back channels, but you're talking about banks with Vishcom Bank and Deutsche Bank. You're talking about people having secret meetings in Seychelles where tens of millions of dollars are going through. You're talking about Jared Kushner, who couldn't find domestic financing for his real estate ventures, but then all of a sudden has these tens of millions of dollars thrown his way from, guess what, transactions that went through banks that are known to launder Russian money. So to sit there and say there's no evidence is ridiculous, because people have been sent to...
No,
it is
okay,
ridiculous.
Okay, I tell you what, can y'all hold on? We got to take a break. Scotty, can you hold on for a minute?
For less evidence.
Who's been indicted? 13 Russians.
Scotty, hold on. We got to take a break, okay? We'll be right back.
Harmony, holy ever. full of the ways that the dark past has taught us. Sing a song full of the hope that the present has brought us. Faith in the rising sun of this day begun. Let us march on, feel victory.
Tune into Just Jazz on Saturday nights from 9 until 11 p.m. right here on Tanya Free and Friends Radio Network. Join me, Ty Bailey, as I showcase the best in jazz, current releases, reissues, and selections from past great recordings. It's all right here on Tanya Free and Friends Radio Network at tanyafree.com. Just Jazz is also streamed 24 hours a day at tybailey.com.
Sponsorship and advertising for the Tanya Free and Friends Talk Show and the Tanya Free and Friends Radio Network is provided by Freedom Marketing Incorporated, 844-321-1010, or email us at info@tanyafree.com for more information.
This is Tanya Free. TanyaFree.com is your destination for the best in social and political straight talk, breaking news, commentary, podcasts, music, and more. Stay in the know. Visit TanyaFree.com today.
The New Orleans Talk Network, now on your mobile device,
on your computer,
in your ear, and interactive. It's new,
it's innovative,
and it's on your mobile device.
Android,
iPhone,
iPad,
and on your computer.
Take us wherever you go.
Because we're interactive. 504-341-TALK. That's 504-341-8255.
Join the conversation. Phone lines are open right now at area code 804-321-1010 in Central Virginia and 844-321-1010 coast to coast.
Okay, I want to welcome also to the panel our friend Clarence McGill. Hey friend, how are you?
Hello, glad to be here.
Well, I'm glad you're here. I'm going to ask the question, do you think 45 can be reelected in 2020? That's the topic of the conversation right now.
Oh, that's the question for me. Well, you know, in the past, I've been accurate. Why?
Oh, my goodness, that's right. You did make that prediction.
Marty, I stayed up all night one night trying to be wrong. I started getting bags in my eyes around sun up, and I went on to bed.
But Marty will verify that. But
you did.
You know what I feel? I feel that this guy will not run for a second term.
Oh, he is running. He officially filed on the day of his inauguration. He's just named his campaign person. He's getting ready to do a tour.
And my prediction was wrong because
I don't know if he's wrong, so he is running.
He's
officially running, but the thing is, if Trump says something,
right,
you just got to dismiss it outright. I don't care if he files paperwork or not.
You cannot dismiss this.
You mark this down. I predict he will be in jail by December.
But let me tell you,
I think he'll be in jail by December.
Okay, my prediction was initially, but with your information, he may run, but I predicted he wouldn't run because he understands the presidency and he knows how to work around it. But secondly, if he does run, he will win. Sadly, has
that
sound?
Because you were right the first time, and you're saying that again this time. Leave. You got to go.
Yeah, I got to go.
So you got to go.
I want to beat myself.
No, you got to go. No, I cannot accept that. But by absolutely no means. No, the reason why he will run again is because running, being in office, is truly profitable for him.
But it's
think about all the money he's been able to make with all the trips to
and
his
the ego
resort.
Boost that he gets.
Yes, and all the connections. And we were talking during the break that Russia owns him and all his dealings. You're talking about all the banks and everything. Yes, he is running.
But you realize in general,
it's to his advantage.
America
and then,
thinks
and
like
then on
this.
Top of that, he likes the power with the authority.
But you know,
he thinks he is it.
You bring up a good point, but I think here's the thing, and this is why I keep going back to the issue. You're saying he's going to win. Well, Trump clearly has awakened, I think, a vocal minority, but he has also awakened a vocal majority of people that just disagree with him. So my thing is, if you have both parties that are vocal, I think it is the majority just based on its vocalness, I guess, if that's
the
term.
But the thing is, the majority, numbers. Though, where... Which way is the majority going?
Only
independent, Democrat. Where? And like I said, I am one of those that's frustrated with the Democratic Party. So which way the majority? Where are we going? Is it going to be divided? Some going to go with the independent. Some going to go with the Democrat. And just splitting the two there will, you know, give him a win.
There will be a single
nominee. That's the question
in the Democrat whittling machine. There will be a single nominee now. The animus towards Trump is so widespread among Democrats, 90% almost, virtually, that you ain't got to worry about Democrats. What we got to worry about and attract are the independents. Mm-hmm. And we don't know enough about the independents and their movement.
Wait, hold on.
It's still too early.
You know, respectfully,
there's been no messaging out of the Democratic camp. And they choose not to out of fear of stinking up the chances for these congressional districts.
And the reason that, you know, by them being quiet is the reason that I think that people are like, okay, the Democratic Party, we're not hearing anything from them. What's their message? What are they planning to do? And that, to me,
The people are speaking in the place of those feelings on March 24th are going to be loud and wild. The Me Too movement is gaining strength. They're online like
but
crazy, mobilizing.
The Democrats cannot take that for granted, just as they did with
it's
Hillary.
It's not for granted.
These are the people, and not the party, that's doing all this activism.
And you know what? I think 100%, 100%, we got activism going on. But this is where I'm going to respectfully disagree with my co-panelist on this. I don't think it is the traditional ball game. And people, whether it's the media or how we're, keep analyzing this situation like it is in normal times. And I think your advice would have been 100% right prior to Trump, that we need to get independence. I think that Trump has done that and pushed independence towards us. So we don't really need to get them. What we need to do is centralize a message, okay, and stop the infighting per se, rather than worrying about getting
independence. Because is that what we had last time?
Infighting with Sanders and Hillary. So we don't need
that
to get
can
the
happen again.
They're coming
and
to
me,
us.
And Sanders didn't show up until they were 2 years out. not 3 years out. I'm telling you,
okay.
We are off schedule if you think that's supposed to happen this year.
I tell you what, 2020, if he is reelected, I'm going to call all y'all out.
Well, you better.
Oh, wait, you wait, 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 because I told you, he is either going to be removed. You saw this post on Monday. He's either going to be unlawfully or lawfully removed from office prior to completing.
I'm waiting
his
for
term.
It.
Now that's real because
if
it's a significant emotional event, if we want to use psychology, happens like you mentioned that something real crazy happens between now and the election in regards to Trump. Yes, he will lose, but if you deal with the western part of Virginia, or upstate New York,
mm-hmm.
or southern New Jersey, or parts of Kansas.
And most of the South.
Most of the South. they like what he's doing.
Sure they do.
They like that he insults women. They like that he insults Native Americans.
And the reason that you there's
a reason he's there, so just
be mindful.
No matter
what he does, they are going to vote for him. We have to be real, real, real mindful of that base he has, that is truly, steadfast.
You've got Mueller. Go ahead.
No, I was going to say, I think that some of that base, I don't think he has that same base number as before, because, and again, some of this is kept out of media, but many of these people who don't really actually understand how politics, works,
mm-hmm.
some of that base that he had prior, they are now like super, super angry. So I don't think he has all of those.
Okay, yeah. Okay.
Okay, as he had, prior to
that, along with the fact
yes.
that Mueller has him in the crosshairs on
that's true.
Conspiracy.
Sure.
Money laundering.
That's the significant emotional event I'm talking about.
What's the other one? Money laundering, conspiracy.
Collusion, all that, yeah.
And there's a third wave of investigation, and actually sedition. Because in fact, a conspiracy is one thing, but it goes overboard when you start looking at how this guy is choosing whether or not to make appointments in embassies and how he's tricking up our foreign affairs. And so, and Jared's gonna spill the beans, poor fella, because he's so dirty he can't even get up in the morning. And once Mueller's finished with him, we're in big trouble.
Wishful thinking. And let me say this.
No, this
okay.
is not wishful thinking. I'm telling you,
okay.
he knows so much more than anything we, the public, can know. He ain't following these leads for anything. And I guarantee you he'll come out with dirty tickets on at least two of those three areas that I just mentioned.
Well,
at least. On Trump himself.
I'm sorry, Marty, I'm not feeling it.
Well, you don't have to.
I'm sorry, I'm not
you don't
feeling
have to.
It. I'm not feeling it.
But let's not
because
forget that.
Because so much that's been going
in
on.
In terms
that,
of his
that,
reelectability.
That,
what if Trump fires
now?
Him? Fires Mueller.
Huh?
What if Trump fires him?
All hell will break
well,
loose.
Well, that's the reason why there's so much rhetoric.
It ain't gonna happen.
Yes, it could. And the reason why he has these tantrums and talking about this steel tariff and all of that and Ryan going against it. He throws stuff out there to get the party's attention that, okay, if you all don't do something with Mueller, this is what I'm going to do just off the cuff. And I think that's on by design, on purpose.
There was an article, too, put out there. I mean, your question, just piggybacking on what you said, is what if Trump goes ahead and fires Mueller. Well, he can't. He's not.
He can't fire.
But
the Republican Party can.
But he can't
fire
Paul
Ryan
Mueller
can.
Specifically. But what he can do is ask Rob Rosenstein to go ahead and or fire Rob Rosenstein.
And Rob Rosenstein said, "I ain't gonna do it."
And essentially, then that would create the issue. But let's also think about this because there's an interesting article about the power vacuum. Michelle Brand, who was a third in line. Okay, we had there were three in line. Jeff Sessions was initially. The top dog on this, the Attorney General.
He's out of it.
He essentially said he recused himself, but I don't think he did. I think there's some issues where they're still playing back and forth.
He can't make that decision.
But anyways, he went ahead and resigned. Recused himself. And then now you have Rob Rosenstein, who is the top dog, but Rachel Brand, who is the third in line to replace Rob Rosenstein, if he would have been fired, already resigned.
Okay.
And so she, now the third in line,
so,
guess what?
So can next be, up is so, this guy who's solicited
Mr. Joe, Mr. Joe, give me about okay. 5 seconds to finish
well,
my
get
notes.
To the okay, point. Wait, the next one wait, up wait, is wait, the wait, Solicitor wait, General.
I like these
wait,
two.
Wait, hold on. I will get to my point when you have a point. How about
okay,
that?
Okay, so, go ahead. All right, let's keep the peace.
We'll do this. No. But, so the problem now is that if Brand is out and she recused herself, it is an appointment. Thanks for knowing nothing, but it's an appointment that Trump has the pick to go ahead and put as third. If Rob is out, he gets a pick in there on a temporary basis.
Yeah.
For 210 days, I believe.
He's right.
That's anybody he wants.
No.
So wait, no, it is. It is a temporary basis. Read the Constitution.
No.
Yes, no, it is. I've already looked at that.
The next pick is the Solicitor General.
Okay. Marty,
all
okay.
three
Marty,
of them right, were out to dinner Marty, just Marty, last
Marty,
week.
Marty, okay. That's not it. If you go ahead and look at the order of succession, not just in the Constitution, but in the DOJ, I think it is the federal statute that goes ahead and looks at that. But anyway, so the problem is, if he can put in anybody he wants to essentially replace Robert for 210 days on a temporary basis before confirmed by Congress,
then he can fire.
Then he can fire
Mueller. Right.
And
exactly.
By the time he does
and
that.
And that's why, well, it could happen. I mean, just think. There are folks dropping out of his administration left and right. Why did Gary Cohen leave yesterday, all of a sudden, his economic advisor? What's behind that?
We all know that the place is in total
true,
pandemonium.
True, but what Tim just said is the scary part. But what Tim just said, we should be concerned because if he fires Mueller, which you just said prior to that, none of that will come true.
What the fact is, forget all of that. If he fires Mueller, then the Congress is on the hook to react.
What, GOP
hold on, hold
Congress?
On.
Okay, let him finish.
Hold on.
Go ahead, Marty.
They
to react
all
in what way?
Elevate Mueller to the highest of the high. They've got to deal with that. Now, then.
They would do
wait,
that.
Wait a minute.
Okay.
Then. The Rosenstein has got the fire.
Okay, I tell you what. Hold that. Though.
Hold that.
We're gonna come back to
he's
you.
Already
go to Black
said
Talk.
I'm not gonna do it.
We gotta go to Black Talk. Commentary. Our friend Scott Reed. Take a listen. So you're saying.
Free and Friends Talk Show is a presentation of Freedom Marketing Incorporated. All rights reserved. Views and comments expressed are not necessarily the views of the host and or this station.
Society once again debates gun control legislation. The Department of Justice is preparing to release documents related to a government gun trafficking scheme that started with the Bush administration and continued for several years into the Obama administration. The scheme allowed criminals linked to drug cartels to purchase thousands of weapons destined to be smuggled into Mexico. Reuters reports the U.S. Justice Department said Wednesday it has reached an agreement with congressional investigators to hand over confidential records about a failed gun trafficking investigation during the Obama administration known as Operation Fast and Furious. Guns tracked by the ATF have been found at crime scenes on both sides of the Mexico-U.S. border and the scene where United States Border Patrol agent Brian Terry was killed in December 2010. The gun-walking operations became public in the aftermath of Terry's murder, according to Humberto Benitez Trevino, a former Mexican attorney general. Related firearms were found at crime scenes in Mexico where at least 150 Mexican civilians were maimed or killed. Revelations of the scheme led to controversy in both countries and diplomatic relations were damaged. As a result of a dispute over the release of Justice Department documents related to the scandal, Attorney General Eric Holder became the first sitting member of a U.S. cabinet to be held in contempt of Congress on June 28, 2012. And earlier that month, President Barack Obama invoked executive privilege for the first time in his presidency over the same documents. In a statement, Attorney General Jeff Sessions said the Justice Department is committed to transparency and will agree to share documents with the U.S. House of Representatives Committee on Oversight and Government Reform that had previously been withheld before President Donald Trump took office. This has been Scotty Reed of BTR News reporting. Support independent media today by giving a tax-deductible donation to the Black Talk Media Project, which has been providing public digital media since 2008.
Are you searching for the best in online black radio? Then go to blacktalkradionetwork.com, helping you filter through the noise. Real talk, Black Talk.
Have you checked out Tanya Free TV on Ustream? Watch our radio broadcast live and catch up on past video podcasts. Download the app or go to Ustream.tv to follow Tanya Free and friends. Stay in touch with us on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram, or text the word Tanya to 63975. Join the conversation. Tanya Free and friends, on air, online, on point.
Conversation. Phone lines are open right now at area code 804-321-1010 in Central Virginia and 844-321-1010 coast to coast.
Marty, I'm going to let you finish making your point before we went to break. When he was talking about
nobody does.
When he was talking about Mueller,
you can't say that to old people.
If he is removed and how the GOP will respond, you said they have to be accountable. Or will?
Yeah, you're talking about two totally different things. We're not talking about. Are we back on?
Yeah, we're back on.
I'm sorry. two different things. We're not talking about the Hatch Act and Kellyanne and that fool's. We're talking about the future survival of the United States as an independent sovereign nation. And the legislators in the Congress would not be allowed to sit on the sidelines and let that all play out by itself.
All right.
They would have to take an action if they fired Mueller.
If they successfully fire
him, and then they fire the next one in line,
another administration, another Republican party. This party,
that's my belief.
They
man.
Are we making up stuff as they go along and could care less. End of story. That's the way it is.
I don't see how they can have any credibility back home if they did not weigh in on this?
For the same reasons that they've had credibility, quote unquote, with their base issues, because their base is not running on credibility. We are in a post-fact era, and I don't know if you realize that, which is why some of these Republicans are not worried about Donald Trump lying day in and day out.
Right.
Their candidates weren't lying day in, day out. We are not running. We're not running the old campaign that you used to run, and
I
you
agree.
Fail to recognize that we are in an entirely different stadium.
Yep.
Okay,
but the numbers have not changed from your base 35%.
Okay. All right. Okay.
And so we can't. None of us can know this. We're only giving opinions here, right?
Okay. All right. Okay.
None of us can.
Well,
know this.
Let me say this. I'm going to shift gears and talk about, you know, one of the issues. Probably. Oh, we got a call. Okay, let's go to the phones right quick. Hey, Myron, how are you, friend?
I'm doing great. How are you?
Good. How about you? I can't hear him. Can you all hear him?
He was breaking up.
Myron, can you give us a call back? We can't hear you, friend. You got a very bad connection.
Yeah, he's breaking up.
You want to talk about the what? Yeah,
okay.
Yeah. We lost them because we couldn't hear him. Sherrod, you were saying something about the military.
Yeah, I was just kind of curious as
parade.
We're talking about everything and the amount of money that and resources that would have to go into that. You know, when you hear about military parades, you hear about that in all, you know, other countries. I was just wondering because I really didn't follow it too much. Has it funding for that been approved?
Oh, I don't know.
They've done cost estimates, and
okay.
We're talking about tens of millions of dollars.
Yeah, sure.
But they have not, from what I've read and up to date, read about that, I don't think that has been necessarily approved, but I think it probably will happen.
Yeah, it's going to happen because it feeds a certain base. That's
because you can't attack it. And look how he's doing this. He's putting
right.
it right on Veterans Day,
Day right.
which I think is right after November 6th or 8th when the elections. It was Veterans Day. It's
right
November 11th,
yeah,
I think.
Mm-hmm.
He's putting this on.
Right.
See, now here's the problem. You can't attack the parade, and they're using it like a Trojan horse. You can't attack the parade because if you attack the parade, you're attacking veterans. And Trump is using it not for the veterans, but to go ahead and pump up his own ego.
Exactly.
And
election,
so,
like you said, around election.
He's using it as a just Trojan horse to do the same thing when he said, hey, instead of recognizing civil rights issues, nope, these football players are taking the knee and they're anti-American. And this is what his base has been confused about time and time again, conflating issues and avoiding facts and going with their own emotions and prejudices.
Right, exactly. Exactly, no question. We got Myron?
Yes.
Hey, friend, how are you?
I'm doing great, Tanya. I just wanted to jump in because in listening, everybody is correct in a perspective, but I think the question is not can he win? The question is will he win? And that is predicated upon all that you guys are discussing.
Well, let me ask do you think will he win?
Well, I mean, it's too early to tell.
You think so?
Yes, I do, because of, first of all, again, you know, right now, Trump has an accomplished.
Can you all hear him?
Lost him.
No.
Myron, we lost you again, Fred.
He's got to switch his cell phone carrier.
Okay. Give us a call
back. It's that cheap phone. I told you about that.
That cheap phone.
All right. Stay focused. One of the things I think that the Democrats need to make an issue of when they, you know, put up whoever they're going to put up, health care is one of those things. For me, net neutrality is another issue that is truly, truly, really important. And I'm really disappointed that the media has not been talking about that a whole lot more, and a whole lot of other issues. And one of the things that we need to do is call our media outlets and tell them the stories that we want them to cover and what we want to hear. I think we need to do that because now it's just it's a whole lot of entertainment.
This goes into like a huge issue because I think your bottom line issue is what does this mean for the practical person
right.
in terms of ending net neutrality?
Talk about what it is because you and I were talking about.
Just a quick summary. Basically, net neutrality is a federal regulation that says that ISPs cannot essentially discriminate, I guess, for lack of a better term, or show preference over internet or content information or
right.
services or applications that come through. So, for instance, if your ISP is like Fios,
Verizon or Xfinity AT&T, Earthlink is another one. They can't then say if you're searching the web page, but because Earthlink is their competitor, that under the current net neutrality rules, they can't then say, well, we don't offer that service from or that content from Earthlink. Therefore, we're going to throttle it down. In other words, you're going to see this loading page, or we're going to prevent access, or we're going to allow you access, and we're going to include it in all these surcharges in your bill. So that's basically what net neutrality does. Is it prevents ISPs
Internet service providers
from forcing their content on you. Because let's say that they may have a contract with a conservative news group like Heritage Foundation or whatever. Well, then the news feeds you see, or vice versa. Let's say you're a conservative and you don't want to see Rachel Maddow show come up, but you may want to see the stuff from the Hermitage. Well, then you're going to have to pay more for that information.
Right.
And if you do, though, want to go ahead and see information or content from a competing source of content or viewpoints or anything, then you're going to start seeing these $3.99 a month charges or these $4.99. So in other words, just like with healthcare, you're paying more for less services or poorer services under the GOP plan.
Right.
This just happens to be with regards to internet and not healthcare.
And what's unfortunate, a lot of people have no idea what net neutrality is and how this got passed by the FCC. And it will become actual law.
I think there's a suit pending.
There are several suits, right? And the thing is, once again, we need to go to our media sources and tell them the stories we want them to talk about and hear about, because a lot of stuff is happening on the down low that we have no clue about until, like you said, we're charged more for internet service or slower or less content. And that's real important. That is key.
The ISPs didn't even admit beforehand. You had a lot of internet service providers, and people suspected or had some sort of suspicion that when they went to different services or whatever that were unusually slow and had longer loading times, that it wasn't because there was a poor connection on their end. It's because that the servers were being manipulated and controlled by the internet service providers as to what content you wanted to see. And they're just put that information out there, just learning that you are under their control. And all this does, ending net neutrality, is furthers the stranglehold on the average consumer, which is Joe Blow, you, myself, whoever uses it, and puts you at mercy to the content and information that the companies and corporations, ISPs, want you to see.
And that's scary. That to me is brainwashing. And
another form of control.
Another form of control. And that is really, 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 really very dangerous. Very dangerous.
Yeah.
So I would, encourage everybody to go to their internet and learn more about net neutrality and call their congressman. Washington, we were talking about the state of Washington, how they just recently passed guidelines where they will not allow net neutrality, what the FCC has put in place.
I think the other thing is, too, and to jump on what you're saying, which is important, Tanya, is that people get energized, get activated about these things, and I think some of the stuff of this perfect storm that helped Trump get into office was this complacency and this apathy with things are going so well with us right now, we don't really need to focus on anything.
Right.
And you look at then this stranglehold with net neutrality. Now, you need to go ahead and IM, depending on what district you're in, you need to IM or Facebook Jeff Bourne or Jennifer McClellan or whoever your representative is on the local and state level and, certainly on the federal level, but I think you're going to have much more success rebuilding from the ground up to say, look, Washington did this, and the bill's gone.
The
state of Washington's done this, and is going to the governor's desk for signature. Why can't we do this in Virginia? Why can't we do this in Florida?
Let me go back to the Democrats. Why has the Democrats been loud about this issue, the FCC passing
this? The same
reason. Why? This is what I'm talking about. Why are they being quiet? Why?
The same reason that they have yet to publicly support the bill that just unanimously passed the General Assembly, both houses, unanimous, to give us a funded plan to fix our schools. Not one Democrat except McClellan, Senator McClellan, has publicly supported the effort. Not one. In fact, they really quietly are opposing it because the mayor opposes it, claiming that it ties his hands and I've got to rob Peter to pay Paul, when in fact we know that just less than a month ago, Time Dispatch reported that Richmond spends double the amount in their budget than do comparable size cities.
Okay, so that said, why do we vote these people back in office?
Well, we, how many times I got to say that?
I know.
We have got to be a we. And the only political game, other than the Democrat Party, the only black political game in town is the Richmond Crusade for voters. I dare you to join next Tuesday.
Well, my thing is,
I think another issue, too, is, I mean, you have...
They don't listen to individuals.
It's not just whether people are pumped up to vote, too. And I think going... this goes on to an issue of control, whether it's the internet, whether it's voting, so on and so forth. And your question specifically to this area, Richmond, Virginia, does the same thing that I disagree with on a larger level. Gerrymanders city districts. You have to get that 5 out of 9 issue. And it's essentially local level gerrymandering, you know, and I heavily disagree with gerrymandering, period. And so the problem is then you get, you know, like when Stoney ran, he put his hopes in the 3rd and 5th district with people who were majority high income white earners. Okay, he wasn't putting his lot and cast in parts of the 3rd and the 2nd and some other places, I think, that were over in Chester. I don't beg to differ because I was out there campaigning and saw where he was putting his signs.
So I want you to hold on.
Hold on. So the problem is not just the getting the energy there. It's also understanding what rules are confining you and really going after the rules and constraints.
Well, I'm going to take a step further. I think that we are at a state and at a point where we have to hold our officials accountable.
Yes.
And let me go back to this net neutrality once again. And this is really, really, really dear to me for the mere fact that it affects us all, everybody, and how they can control what you can and cannot see or cannot have access to or charging you. That's an issue. That is a huge issue. And I cannot understand why the Democrats have not jumped on the bandwagon about this issue. I just don't understand that.
Well, because we haven't demanded that they do. Tim Kaine,
that's a problem.
When we were fighting to get minority participation in procurement with the state of Virginia, Tim Kaine was governor. We met with him, and we had a plan that's been circulating around state from other communities of color for a while. And his response was, make me do it.
He's right. He's absolutely right. And we need to make
our politicians
do it. If we don't
make him do it, which means publicly advocate for it, then you got nothing.
You got a pink elephant.
Everybody has a Facebook page and social media, you know, access to social media in some way. Go online and vote and voice the topics that you want folks to see and encourage folks to contact their congressperson.
You have a pink elephant in the room, and that is the economy. The economy looks like it's booming a little bit. Now,
that's because of President Obama. It's getting ready to unravel.
Well, there's still that elephant, that big elephant in the back of the room. And so everything, sometimes your economy is your fulcrum to a lot of issues in regards to any politics. So,
and the link between the economy and what we're talking about is
I'm just saying there's a link. As long as people
are... Well, let me ask you. You said it's booming. How? In what way? I mean, I haven't seen my income
increase. In terms of...
You didn't get a $1.50 increase like Paul Ryan when he said that.
Right, exactly. They talk about this tax cut. I'm still waiting for the break. Where the increase?
There's plenty of jobs. Just dealing with it locally from the...
what kind of jobs are you talking about?
That's what I'm going to say.
We're going to talk about that. Today's Jazz Break is 2-2 by Miles Davis, sponsored by Hong Kong Tailors in Richmond. We'll be right back.
Tanya Free and Friends Talk Show is sponsored in part by
Hong Kong Custom Tailors is celebrating 50 years in Richmond. Visit their brand new expanded showroom, 1839 West Broad. Custom ready to measure suit for less than authorized suits at other retailers. Custom monogrammed shirts, pants, sports coats, overcoats, designer shoes, headwear, women's fashions, expert alterations, and more. Hong Kong Custom Tailors, 1839 West Broad, 359-5441.
There are so many ways to listen at Peachtree Radio FM. Go to rsgame.org, download the RS Game web client while playing your game, press Control B and arrow down to Peachtree Radio FM. Also, dial the telephone number 641-552-5194. Download the Peachtree Radio FM app from the App Store and Google Play Store. Listen at Peachtree Radio FM on TuneIn Radio, iBlink Radio, and the new website, PeachtreeRadioFM.net. There are so many ways to listen at Peachtree Radio FM. Well, some listen to remember and some listen to forget.
The Tanya Free and Friends Talk Show is sponsored in part by
Furniture at the Venus. Hi, I'm Chocolate Chip, and your home is the place that says the most about who you are. Furniture at the Venus has a huge selection of styles that make a statement. Visit our showroom at 1420 Hull Street, Suite A, and check out our full line of dining room sets, living rooms, and bedroom sets, and more. Be sure to ask about our weekly Tanya Free and Friends specials on everything in the store, including king and queen mattresses, sets to fit any budget. With new arrivals daily, let Charles and Nancy Shaw show you their complete line of home furnishings and accessories. Give them a call at 804-232-3500. That's 804-232-3500. That's Furniture at the Venus, 1420 Hull Street, in the heart of Southside Richmond.
Phone lines are open right now at area code 804-321-1010 in Central Virginia and 844-321-1010 coast to coast.
give it up or send you to China.
Okay, you're saying that the economy is booming, and let me ask this question. So
I said the economy is apparently it's doing well. Yeah. Let me booming is a whole different perspective, but it's
doing well. Okay.
Well, the economy certainly is a part of what we were talking about. We sort of got off track.
That's what I mean.
Talking about this economy piece, when in fact we're talking about electoral behavior. Correct. But again, back on track, I think maybe you would need to tell me, remind me where we were.
Net neutrality is what we were talking about.
Net neutrality,
about.
That's
and I
right.
said that's one of the key issues that the Democrats should have been yelling and screaming about. Because it will change the dynamics, especially if you are looking for a job and, you know, using the internet and how that will truly impact you tremendously.
And given that corporations are buying up these corporations like crazy,
yes.
like Pac-Man, if the right wing controls all the media, then they control the content.
Right.
They
which controls
control your thoughts.
Exactly.
That's that social, emotional.
Yeah, that's dangerous.
That's why net neutrality is extremely important.
But one of the bigger issues, again, as we were talking about, I'm glad you asked, you know, to please define it, because many people don't know.
Exactly.
I've had conversations with grown people who have no idea what it is, and they were completely disinterested. And
mm-hmm. Right.
Doesn't understand
but try to go,
enormity of how it impacts them directly.
Oh, when they try to get online, they can't go to certain
right.
content or
right.
they can't do what they normally do.
Or not,
right.
Bill,
right.
That, and then you no longer can afford basic cable.
Right, they're going to be like, what the heck? Yeah, especially young people.
Mm-hmm.
But you
oh
make a
goodness.
Good point that Virginia can pass its own law with
just
regard
like
to
Washington,
state
of Washington, like Washington did, yes.
And we can't get the legislature to even think about it until they are bombarded with information and demand. And I suggest let's put a task force together and a campaign to do just
okay.
that.
You got
do
it.
The crusade
okay.
for voters.
Okay.
Huh?
When is the meeting? When are we going to do it, Marty? I'm very
next
serious.
Next Tuesday night.
We're going to put a campaign together on this particular issue. That's what you're saying?
The crusade meets next Tuesday
okay.
night. We can put it together between now and Friday.
Okay.
And have something
can you
to
help
propose.
Yeah, I mean, sure.
Yeah, that's a good idea.
Well, I think
yeah, because
my,
this is key.
This is huge, man.
This is
and the people are unsuspecting.
I think my mom has better contacts with regards to Crusade, and certainly.
Well, we need you.
You
know, you're my man, and you are. You are no. I don't mean that your mama ain't smart.
Mr. Jewell must have got my check. He must have got my check. I sent it to you last week and it just
leave me alone,
just,
man.
Because I was wondering where that deduction from my bank account came.
Leave me alone.
I
I'm trying to say to you that we need you to attract other young people because you think so much different. We've got a generational problem in the black community, y'all.
Nope.
If you haven't noticed.
I agree with that.
Sure
we
do.
And we wind
well,
up fussing
that,
and losing
with,
valuable talent.
With the party, period.
Because, I ain't talking about no party. I'm talking about...
Well, you always talk about the party. All of a sudden, you don't want to talk about the party now?
I'm not a member of the party.
Oh, really? What part?
No.
Oh, okay.
No.
The question
when
is
did that
yes.
change?
The question is yes before
done.
This even happens. Now, yeah, I can help you, but I think we had a question coming up. But the question is
that's
yes before.
Acid, what? Could yeah, block I, black talk?
They could, not based on race, but they get around that by blocking out
content. Right.
You see what I'm saying? So
exactly.
there are ways to get around things. They're not going to say, well, this is black talk.
Well, this gives,
no,
this gives
is
them...
The content is not stuff.
Right, exactly. This gives them full control as to what you can and cannot, and the speed as well. You may be trying to wait for something.
Or they intentionally
pop-up.
Throttle it down so that
right.
you do what? Get tired of waiting for the thing to load and go back to their content.
Right.
And
right.
so my thing is, like, I don't want to see, you know, let's say I have Fios. I don't know this for certain, but, you know, let's say I have Fios or whatever, and they have some contract with, you know, some right-wingers. I don't want to see news feeds from Fox News.
Right.
Me personally.
This is
and then
is
I don't
want
to get charged because I decided
let me
to
tell you
get
how big it is.
Outside of
let me tell you how big it is. White folks are scared to death that they are becoming, by 2050, a distinct minority, right? And they're demonstrating the anxiety with those who...
2015, we...
By 2050.
2050,
okay.
Hispanics are supposed to, I think, be
right.
the largest minority.
People of color will be the majority in America by 2050.
Mm-hmm.
It's driving white people crazy. And so what they're doing is consolidating political power right now. And economic power. Right now, that was the gist of Donald Trump's Tax. It was a tax reform bill. Mm-hmm. It wasn't a tax cut bill, right? And they're reforming it to further enrich rich white people.
Oh yeah, it did. No question. Yes.
Everybody knows
that's so good about
this. Please let me finish. Because to eliminate net neutrality is a part of this whole scheme. They don't mind becoming a minority as long as they maintain the power to control the majority.
Right.
And they'll do it through politics, they'll do it through money, and they'll do it through messaging.
Messaging, mentoring, and emotional conditioning.
Net neutrality, there's tax cuts.
There's no other reason for them to do this.
Okay.
It's conditioning, because it does fuel the base. When you have conditioning, it fuels the base.
Exactly. And that's another issue.
When you hear enough of whatever it is, the message is.
Well, you know what kills me? Is that's why I had to laugh, is because it's exactly going on. We said, look, it's in their messaging is how they said, what, tax reform? Mm-hmm. This is just power reconsolidation.
So yes! That's exactly what it is.
You could have used reconsolidation
as reform,
but reform sounds a bit more acceptable.
Right, sure. And that's the other issue we need to talk about. This tax cut they just approved, people thinking if you're not in the 1%, you're out of luck.
Sure.
You are out of luck because a lot of the things that they have cut back, the things you're used to getting credit for, you will not get. And a lot of people don't realize what they are. We're going to talk about that, hopefully, maybe.
Oh, when you're poor, you're going to realize, when you need some health care.
Oh, yeah.
And here's what kills me. I don't think, the greatest issue with the GOP has been to fool those that do not share the same economic interest or power, really the poor whites and middle income and poor whites, to go ahead and jump on their agenda for the rich whites. This is, you know what kills me? This is the same, you can say, argue truly that both parties use manipulation and tax to go ahead and consolidate their base. But I think what's so interesting is you can certainly see this, whether it was the Civil War, where rich whites really had to fool poor whites into going ahead and giving their lives to do what? Enrich the white. And we are seeing the same thing here.
Mm-hmm.
Where it's like rich whites have to fool poorer whites to go ahead and back the rich whites to remain in power.
True. Yeah. This is true.
And let me take more of your money, because we need to control all the money to help your poor white behind.
But we're not really helping you, but we're not going to tell you we're not helping you. We're going to go ahead.
Back to your question in the beginning, that's why he may not have the support of his base. Because now, again, the money transcends color. So therefore, some of those hateful people, I'll just say, that supported him, initially, I think he's already lost many of them in terms of supporting his base.
Well, we're talking let's clarify what we're talking about. In terms of his core base, he has not lost one person.
Because you raised
in terms of his base, I think it's boiled down to the core base. I'm talking about
41%. He's down to 35% and holding.
No, not his core base. Not the core base. But, some of them he's lost.
He has lost.
Mm-hmm. No, I would agree in terms of his base overall. But I think we have to start just clarify terms. There's a core base where you're not going to crack into it. That's not diamond. That's that lump of coal under pressure. That's that diamond for him. You're not going to cut into that.
Let me go back to raising money once again. Because when we think about him raising massive amounts of money, and Rubio was backed into a corner a few weeks ago asking whether or not he would not accept
NRA
money, funds. And they are the ones that are controlling things. And I say money makes a big difference. Now, a lot of times when we think about candidates receiving money, we probably think Republicans, but Democrats receive money as well. And that's why I said we have to be real careful when we talk about the Democrats in regards to my question once again, why aren't they yelling and screaming about things that we care about, holding the Republicans accountable? And my thing is this, we have to be, careful as to are they being paid and bought as well. Do not allow our vote to be taken for granted anymore. Citizens United, right. Right.
Citizens United.
Let me such that corporations can.
May I?
Go ahead.
Citizens United made it so that money can buy politicians.
Mm-hmm.
And they are. And so there's very little black folk can do about that, because money is power, and they extract their power from the money. We don't have... Wait. Yeah. We'll get into that in a minute, but the fact is, ain't much we can do about...
Oh, no. Wait stop, a Marty. Minute. Don't ever say nothing we can do.
I said there's not much we can...
Yes, we can. Yes, we can.
Let me get it out of my mouth, then.
No, I'm not. No. Ooh. I refuse, to accept that. No, we can do anything we want to do. President Obama received $27?
One thing I advocated a long time ago.
That's not what I'm talking about.
Okay, what are you talking about?
There's not much we can do between now and the end of Trump's tenure that's going to make much of a difference.
I disagree.
We need to be planning for what we need to do. The hell with the Democrat Party. The hell with any other party. We need to be planning on what's best for us.
Didn't we just say we're going to... start a campaign with regards to net neutrality?
That's one thing.
It's a lot we can do.
I'm not talking about just us here at this table.
Well, people listen to us.
Black folk.
Isn't that what this platform is for?
I'm saying black folk generally can't do much to impact what's going on.
I'm going to have to highly disagree with that because until we organize on the local, there's no way.
Okay, we all can do, whether we organize or not, everybody can do something. Even if you do it by yourself on social media, internet, Facebook, or whatever, unless it's organized effort
that will impact those who make the honorable gentleman yield his time.
Clarence, go ahead.
You remember apartheid when America was supporting the effort to defeat apartheid, and we started, the world started boycotting certain products. I know Colgate was involved, and when we started boycotting those products, you know, things came around. If we started a boycott a week from now, and we said, for example, and I don't know, just hypothetically, nobody black go into a McDonald's for a month. Marty, if we did that, and it was effective, and if the right person said it, maybe an Obama or maybe Mrs. Obama to organize it, somebody of trust, you can believe that America is going to pay attention. Because number one, they're going to say, uh-oh, these black folks understand the power, their economic power, number one, finally.
I totally agree.
And number two, we're not going to, racism is going to be limited because now we're hitting the pocket of America, the budget of America.
Totally agree.
So when you say we can't do anything, if we were organized...
I wasn't allowed to finish my point. Until we organize on the ground level to make these things happen that can be impactful, we got nothing. Otherwise, it doesn't happen by itself.
Tim.
Well, I just wanted to see where Mr. Jewel was going with this. I don't know if he knew where he was going, but I mean, here's the thing. I'm just going to have to disagree.
Do I have to take this?
Yes, you did. You did.
I'll be going.
I think Clarence had a great point. Is the issue is, and I don't know, you know, if it's this old way of things used to be. I've said this before. We are beyond just voting. Okay, we are beyond, especially with Russia looming into, like, who knows of whether they're going to go to active measures and have developed software to actually change votes. I don't know, and certainly the head brass doesn't know.
What information they can feed us with this net neutrality.
So I think the issue is that we've gone beyond voting, and we need to take a page out of the playbook from the 50s and 60s that you don't have to have money, but if you can deny the other person from getting money, that's just as effective.
Right.
I'm Mrs. Fannie Lou Hamer, and I farmed on the Marlow Plantation for 18 years. I had charge of keeping up with the time and paying off, and I went down the 31st of August to try to register. And after I had gotten back home, Mr. Marlow told me that I would have to go down and withdraw my registration or leave. because they wasn't ready for that in Mississippi. And I said, Mr. Marlowe, I'm trying to register for myself. So I had to leave that same night after I had gone down in August. And then I spent one night with Mrs. Tucker, and after about 2 days in September, they shot in the house 15 times, thinking that I was there.
Yesterday we used to rock the show. I laced the track, you locked the flow. So far from hanging on the block of dough. Notorious, they got to know that life ain't always what it seemed to be. Words can't express what you mean to me. Even though you're gone, we still a team. Through your family, I'll fulfill your dreams. In the future, can't wait to see if you open up the gates for me. Reminisce sometime, the night they took my friend. Try to black it out, but it plays again. When it's real, feeling's hard to conceal. Can't imagine all the pain I feel. Give anything to hear half your breath. I know you're still living your
every
life after death.
Every step I take, every move I make, every single day, every time I pray, I'll be missing you. Thinking of the
us while we pray for you. Every day we pray for you. Till the day we meet again. In my heart is where I keep a friend. Memories give me the strength I need to proceed. Strength I need to believe. My thoughts big, I just can't define. Wish I could turn back the hands of time. Us in the six, shopping new clothes and kicks. You and me taking flicks, making hits. Stages they receive you on. Still can't believe you're gone. Give anything to hear half your breath. I know you're still living your life after death.
Did you know on July 28, 1903, Maggie Lena Walker established the St. Luke's Penny Saving Bank, becoming the first female bank president of any race to charter a bank in the United States? My name is Aaliyah Cook, and I am living life with a purpose with Tanya Free and Friends.
The Tanya Free and Friends Talk Show is sponsored in part by
Marion Marketing Global. You know those guys over at Marion Marketing Global? They can do everything from billboards to bus signs. Marion Marketing Global, changing the world and expanding your brand every day, each day. Marion Marketing Global, 804-938-5218. Check us out on the web at marionmarketingglobal.com.
We'll be right back.
Join the conversation. Phone lines are open right now at area code 804-321-1010 in Central Virginia and 844-321-1010 coast to coast.
Okay. We were talking during the break. You said the meeting for the Crusade for Voters is what day? Because we're going to work on this net neutrality issue.
And we are inviting all of your listeners.
This is in Richmond.
To join us here in Richmond, Virginia, next Tuesday at 7 p.m. at the Richmond Crusade for Voters meeting. It's a 62-year-old organization that
address.
I don't have the address, but it's at the Military Retirees Club on Chamberlain Avenue.
We'll post it.
At 7 o'clock.
Okay.
Somebody asked me something.
Yeah, we're going to post it. Also, too, we're going to get. You said the bill from Washington State. You can send me the link, and we'll try to.
Oh yeah, I certainly want to go ahead and so everybody's not trying to wait on me, but I'm going to also provide you the information. But just so all your listeners know, additionally, anything that has to do with legislation is public information. Right. That is online. You can go to your state or federal government. It's usually .gov. Like Virginia.gov is the Virginia site. I'm sure Washington State is probably Washington.gov or whatever. You can go online and get these. But certainly I'm going to send Tanya a link if the bill's too lengthy. I don't know how many pages it was. The tax plan was, I think, 426 pages. I'm sure you don't want like that. But we'll see.
Okay.
Or the summary. I should say or the summary.
Okay.
Along with the Crusade for Voters, we ask everybody to join. It's only $15 a year, a whole year. And so we've got multiple committees to get people working on. It's the only black political game in town.
Okay. Gotcha. Tim, we're going to answer Chris's question. Chris asked if the internet service providers could block Black Talk Radio Network and this show, Tanya Free and Friends.
And that was a huge issue that a lot of small timers, I would say, not these mega corporations, but all you need basically is to incorporate in the proper FCC licensing to go ahead and actually, in the available bandwidth or space to go ahead and become an ISP provider, okay? Because you can be a limited one in a small area or you can be a big one. And the problem is when you have these huge companies, they can drown you out in a heartbeat.
That's the issue. Yeah.
And so you can't, and that was another issue. What if I'm on like, I don't know, Tim Smith ISP provider? I'm a small, I've got a broadcast area.
Content provider.
And I've got a broadcast area of maybe like five blocks. I don't know if the bandwidth, but well, if AT&T don't want me to go ahead and show my wares or my goods, or I've got content which they disagree, then they can essentially shut me out of business before
or
I even
charge
start.
Me.
That's the fear.
Or charge me out of business before I even start.
Right,
you know?
Because that's what can happen. I think companies like Netflix and Amazon are content providers. Ooh. So they could be charged more or would limit what they would able to provide us because of internet service providers.
And this goes on to the a larger issue that I think Mr. Jewell actually hit on a valid point. This is all a consolidation of power.
Yes.
And it's whether it's in the, you know, you can't sit here and say, well, there's no evidence, like some of our callers in said, there's no evidence of Russian collusion, which is nonsense. But, you know, then not understand the level of American propaganda from, guess what, the companies that want to maintain a disequilibrium for their benefit.
Well, and it's happening for the mere fact that all of the craziness that we're seeing on the media now, I mean, I can turn on main, you know, media sources and you know, watch it for 5 minutes, and it's just so crazy, I turn it off. Because it's just a distraction. That's all it is. Distraction. And these types of subjects.
It's social and emotional control.
Right, exactly.
You know, it's deliberate. It's designed
by design.
That way. Yeah.
Exactly. So these are the type of stories with this, the tax bill. There's a whole lot more out there that we have to be real careful of that is happening behind the scenes, the FCC, how this got passed. And a lot of people don't know, have any idea.
And I think, well, you know, and this is good, if this Democratic suit goes forward, or, and I think they're actually, I forget the congressman that's working on a bill to go ahead and see if they can repeal this net neutrality issue. It's the way you do things, too, and the Democrats are using the Congressional Review Act to repeal.
CRA. Mm-hmm.
And the reason why the CRA is so important is that's how Trump has been tearing down Obama's accomplishments. And just to go ahead and quickly summarize what the CRA is, it means that essentially it's a congressional rule that if legislation is repealed, then substantially similar legislation cannot be put back in place regarding what was repealed. So you don't have this back and forth issue. So if something is gone and you use the CRA, the Congressional Review Act, to do it, you can use other means, but if you use the CRA to do it, it is gone if it is substantially similar to the earlier legislation that was passed. So that's how Trump is tearing up these tracks, because now we have to go through the extra trouble of finding out a new way to address the same problem.
It is
to repeal it probably would take a super majority to make it happen, right? Or does it?
No, they lowered the rules. Remember, they lowered the rules. That whole nuclear option when they tried to get Gorsuch, it used to be 60 votes. And I think now it is 51.
Okay.
There you go. He's right. And right about that, I remember that.
Mm-hmm. So there are a lot of things that he has undone.
That may not be able to be brought back in the same, well, number one, at all, but if they are, in the same manner that they were.
Right. And this one just happened to be real, I mean, a key for me, but there were other things that he has undone that I want to talk about, too. Mm-hmm. Probably some of the other things on next week. Because, I mean, that affects us, and people won't realize until it's already a done deal.
I mentioned the Crusade, but the Crusade, the NAACP, those are legacy advocacy organizations whose biggest contribution they make is advocacy. And I would think the state NAACP might want to take a bite out of what we're talking about with net neutrality.
Well, my question is, why haven't they already?
Because we've all been sitting on our hands for the last 15, 20 years.
And just why is that?
You ain't got enough time.
Mm-hmm.
But by and large,
well, I mean,
that's a good question. I don't know that I know the answer to that.
Complacency.
But
y'all have heard me say it over again, Crusade ain't Crusade, NAACP ain't CPA.
And that's where that angers me. That's why we are where we are.
But we have allowed
And when
it
you
that
say
happen,
that we can't, we can. We all have a voice that
I
has to be heard.
Can. Now, don't keep saying that. I said
that's what I'm hearing.
Little
that's what I'm hearing.
No, you never let me finish, okay. So you didn't hear it. There's precious little impact we can make until we organize locally on the ground and make the effort.
And the reason I refuse to accept that, just look at all the young people that has made a major impact.
Biggest
with regards to this shooting.
It started locally.
Right, but look at the impact they've made.
It started locally to organize me.
Now, and I disagree with that. This is why I said the event that occurred, the school shooting, happened locally.
Yes.
But these teenagers were on Twitter. So essentially, even though the
social
physical
media
event
once
happened
again.
Literally, they were in China as soon as it happened.
You're talking about the mechanics of proliferating an event. I'm with you there.
And what do you call it? A significant emotional event.
We have a birthday. Birthday. Woo! Tim Bassett, happy birthday. Woo!
Thank you.
Tim, happy birthday. Yes, it is.
I am 21.
Square 21 square.
That's fake.
You know
fake whatever.
That. Yeah, I'm twice that.
Yeah, fake whatever.
Thank
happy birthday, sweetheart.
Thank you, everybody. Thank you.
But that wasn't twice. That's 21 times 21.
I use good skincare products. Thank you. This is good. Yeah, you have a knife?
Yeah, we're going to cut it in a few minutes and get some plates
Tanya
and everything.
Tanya doesn't let me around the knives anymore.
That's, especially when you're close to Marty. Especially when you're close to Marty. We don't want you to do that. You're a little too close for that. But no, we have to let our voices be heard and do like the young people did in Florida. Like you said, they got on social media. That's why net neutrality, this issue, is key.
You think if the internet provider didn't let the access for just like they do in China or Russia, where they're saying, well, actually Russia with this new hooker story coming out that says she has the goods on Trump and all that stuff. Well, what's Russia threatening to do? Cut off her Instagram account and cut off her Facebook post. So if you let the government, or really in our case, it's not the government that is controlling it to a degree. It is private corporations that have just the same power to go ahead and do the government
does. Have they done it already? Was it last week there to be a demonstration or a celebration in Tiananmen Square in China? And they shut down all of the media, social media?
Tiananmen Square, that was in 1990.
I know, but I'm saying there was to be a commemoration
I don't know.
I think it was just this past week.
I don't know.
And they shut down communications on it, so it
didn't happen. The same direction.
That's my point.
The same direction. Oh, my God, that is scary. That is extremely scary. When you have, especially being that now social media is a main source of control. I mean, same main source of communication. You know, with people. I mean, you can go
nothing on broadcast or cable media.
You know what's scary?
Tell us what happened with that.
And I think, just piggybacking on, it's not just corporation control in general. It is given Trump which corporations he may have a financial interest or stake in, that the GOP, if not him himself, but certainly his family, will piggyback to sell their crap.
Oh, yeah.
And consolidate around that.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. That's why we have to be real careful when we talk about can he or will he be reelected. Yeah, that can happen. Yeah, it can happen. Because of what, he's connected to these corporations. He's giving them this big tax break. Money makes a world of difference.
I think that's...
Social media, all of that.
I think that's a possibility. I don't think it's a probability. Okay, when you say, can he be elected? Yeah, it's a possibility. I could be king of the world next week. But I don't think it's probable that either of the two will occur.
We didn't think that last time, but the first time. But anyway, it's always a thank God.
We have more information now. I don't think that everybody's going to follow that same path.
Okay, we'll see, ladies.
Preach, sister, preach.
As always, I thank God, my Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, for allowing us the opportunity to speak and hopefully hear. Thanks to our listening friends. Blessings to each and every one of you. Of course, happy birthday, Tim. Thank you so much. Marty Niles.
Happy birthday,
and
Tim.
And Clarence Niles, Noah Marcus, and Mr. Friend. I'm telling you, see, until next time, be free. And remember to live life with a purpose.
Free and Friends Talk Show is a presentation of Freedom Marketing Incorporated. All rights reserved, views and comments expressed are not necessarily the views of the host and or this station.